See what I call, my heaven must open by fire. My heaven must open by fire. So many things is going on in the life of many people, both believer and unbeliever. But in the life of believer, it's becoming an issue of concern. Many have prayed, many have fasted, many have sowed seed, many have even do all terrible of things, many have slept inside church, many have even go every places, but still yet the result is not coming. Why? Because something that is very, very terrible that people don't pay attention to, it's what is causing the whole confusion, which is closing heaven. When you have done all this thing I mentioned and you discover that your life is still going in the same pattern, you need to cry out here this morning, because automatically you are under a closing heaven. Let's open our Bible to Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 12. Deuteronomy 28 verse 12. Say, the Lord will open for you his good storehouse, the heaven to give rain to your land in the season, and to bless all the work of your hand, and you shall lend to many nations, but you shall not borrow. You shall lend to many nations, you shall not borrow. That is when your heaven is open. You shall have access to abundance. You shall not be in sorrow. When heaven is open, you will not be in sorrow. You will be in abundance. So when heaven is not open, struggle will be the order of the day. I want you to understand something here this morning. Every strong battle comes from heavenlies. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12. Just like I said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality and power, against power in high places. The battle that is going on against the nation, against individual, company, career, marriage, is from heavenlies. Now, as you know, the Bible said to me, and I would like you to open your Bible there, every good thing comes from above, which is from heaven. James chapter 1, verse 17. Every good thing, perfect and good gift of God, come from above. So if every good thing comes from above, and that above is locked, what will happen? Are you asking yourself that question right now? Every perfect gift, a wonderful gift, come from above. James chapter 1 verse 17. If there's a fast read that they open and read. James chapter 1 verse 17. Every good gift and perfect gift is from above. And come down from the Father's of light. That means your perfect gift is from above, not from earth. I will lift up my eyes to the hill where comes my help. My help come from heaven, right? Did he say your help come from down? No. That is why the devil is attacking many believer heavens. And they help the devil to attack it. Am I still talking to someone here this morning?
Yes.
Beloved, if there is anything you and I need to do here today, is to pray our heaven to open. Until your heaven open, there will be no blessing. You will not have access to some certain things. And when a man is under close heaven, when anyone is under close heaven, calamity will be order of the day. Sickness will increase. Dryness will be all over. Hard labor will be what you start to see. Hardship is what is going to be happening. Famine is what is going to be happening. Attack upon attack is what is going to be happening when a man or woman is under close heaven. In the First Kings chapter 17, when the people go against the will of God, Elijah closed the heaven. The Bible recorded that there was a serious famine in the land. People were running up and down. Nobody had anything to eat. The kings and the queen were troubled because there is a closed heaven. Place your right hand on your head. Say, wherever my heaven is closed, mercy of God, open it this morning. Somebody open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. It doesn't matter the year you have been a Christian, beloved. Let me say this to you. You can be apostle, you can be bishop, you can be prophet, you can be anything. When your heaven is closed, you'll be living in a past glory. A lot of pastors are going up and down now, their heaven is closed. A lot. Even some, their heaven have not opened at all. A lot. They call themselves by title. I know when my heaven opened, and since that time, my life never remained the same. July 26, 2007. After I finished some certain prayer, and the Lord said to me, your heaven opened now. And I saw heaven open clearly. That is why I tell you, when God speaks to you, you will remember the date. It's only a liar that said, God speaks to me now, I didn't remember. Who are you? Obama speaks to you, you keep the date. Obama is 2 months. Dayton, the governor of Minnesota, if you make a phone call to you, you won't forget it for the rest of your life. So how much more Almighty God talk to you and you say, I can't remember, but God spoke. Who are you? The Bible tells me, he spoke once, twice I've heard. All power belongs to him. When God speaks to you, it will echo for the rest of your life. You will document it. You can't forget it if God really talked to you. Yes. That's why I ask questions. When he said God speaks to you, and he talked to me, so you didn't remember. You didn't hear him. Call to me anywhere. You didn't hear him. If you hear God, you will know you hear God. You can't forget it. 2004, September, in the 2 p.m. when he spoke to me, I'm taking you to the United States of America and I will make you to have a ministry. The whole world will know you from there. It's still on my mind. I didn't write it down, but I write it in my brain. I can't forget. 2 p.m. After 5 days dry fasting, all afternoon, I said, let me not relax. And he cut up and he appeared to me. February 25, 2 o'clock in afternoon, 2007. I saw Jesus live with angels. Say, this is the angel of your ministry. How do you forget the such as evident? It's an encounter you forget. When your heaven open, you don't forget it. Amen. Then ask pastor, ask some prophet. You say, God speaks to you. When? Tell me. Now you can't remember. You are dumb. You don't. Here go. Challenge anyone that cannot remember the day. He didn't hear God. He only tell himself. It's a fallacy. Hello?
Hi.
You can't have a fantastic dream about your life if you don't remember. It will document your brain for the rest of your life. A dream that changed your story, you won't forget it. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
You have to tell and say the truth. Enough of false prophet up and down. God said this to me. God said this to me. God said 5 words to you. No one happened. Can God be a liar?
No.
No. If that is God speaking, you will see evidence. Hello? Beginning of this point, he told us it's a fruitful evidence. Yeah. He has shown in every area. Mm-hmm. Under one more, 10 car, new. Yeah. Brand new. And it's still coming.
Yeah. Amen.
I said it's still coming.
Amen.
Every evidence show in everywhere when he speaks. It's your tongue for evidence.
Yeah.
If you're saying, let me be born again.
Yeah.
So when there's a level of your open heaven. The level of your open heaven will determine the progress, success, breakthrough you will talk about. The level of your open heaven. Heaven open by volume. Some open little. Some open wide. Some the heaven tear, blast. And that is what we are going on with here today.
Yeah.
We are going with the heaven that will blast.
Yeah.
Our heaven is open. people more than each other. And it costs us to receive. That is why in Isaiah 64 verse 1, he said, all thou that may render ever open. Thou may render, that means as you tear ever open for my sake. That's why I would advise you, everyone that want to capture something different, please don't miss this prophetic praise. It's not about advertising church, it's advertising Jesus. Amen. Anywhere you praise from the heart, you call attention of open heaven.
Amen.
It's your time for great testimony.
Amen.
I said something to one of my pastors. I said, if it's God, it's miracle. If without God, no miracle. When you see God in a place, a role, a policy change. Things that they say cannot work will change. Everything that they say is impossibility on your door, in your life, after today, God change it.
Amen.
I say God will change it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your open heaven will determine your word command. You are talking about money. You cannot make money when your heaven is not open. So many people are doing 4-3 job now. 8 hours here, 8 hours here, 8 hours here. Ask them $200, they still have to go and do another 8 hours. It's because heaven is closed. 5 o'clock, even your children is no longer see your face. They ask you, is that your mom? You look like my mom. Hello? It's just so I've overpicked the hours. Nobody knows you at all. And stay here, the purpose you pick the hours for, you do the work. Not the show. If you are going to buy a cloth for any outing, you have to pick hour. Hello? They call location. Okay, the cloth that we are taking this location is going to cost us 150. Okay, wait. Did you have our I need our. It's an insult. That means you don't have reserve. Hello?
Hi.
Pastor Adebayo told us one thing when we went to go and have a conference with him. Say people are just rejoicing in debt in America. They are rejoicing in debt in America. Some carry BB chain in their neck. But God will live in America. Now when you check, the debt is like this, huge. He cannot move for a 1 week outside America, his mind will not be at rest. Because you are in debt. It's heaven that is closed. What you are paying hour for 3 days, 5 hours that you are keeping hour for, when heaven opens, you have reserve. You do a little job, abundant God.
Amen.
That is what you are expressing from now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When there is close heaven, total confusion will be order of the day. When there is a close heaven, untimely death will be rampant. When there is close heaven, there will be no genuine revelation. There will be no clear vision. People will not have access to what God speaks. Because God will not speak to you. When he close heaven, you will not hear him. Hello?
Hi.
That is why in the whole world now, it's just only few people that hear God anymore. Everybody is just using idea. People are only using idea now. And God said, the things you said from beginning to the end, God did not show up inside. Can God speak and not back his word up? It's a lie. People of God, we need to cry out. We need to know when heaven is closed. We need to know when heaven is open. People are going to church now. Church are becoming a comedy zone. Entertainment. It's not supposed to be like that. It's supposed to be a place of delivering and power.
Amen.
Hello?
Hi.
If you want to be entertained, go to comedy club. If you are still coming to church, you are expecting that anyone that holds microphone and is still making you to laugh over now, is a drive zone. It's a drive zone. I'm telling you the truth. When you step out of a church and you couldn't realize that you get something out of it that boils your spirit, that will make you feel like, Lord, something needs to happen. My story needs to change. I need to change my pattern. You are in a dry zone, beloved. I need to tell you the truth. Christianity is not of a world, it's of power. I'm not here to entertain you. I'm not a comedian. Whenever it's closed, a pastor becomes a comedian. Whenever it's closed, a pastor begins to entertain all manner of things just to gather money. Nobody will tell you the truth. You'll see liar and say, okay, God, we understand. Let's just keep pushing it. Oh, God forbid.
Amen.
I refuse to be part of it.
Amen.
Hello?
Hi.
Major heaven shakers, they are the one who their heaven is open. Amen. When your heaven is open, your voice will be recognized.
Amen.
Say, my heaven.
My heaven.
Open by fire.
Open by fire.
Open your mouth and pray that prayer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Before Jesus Christ started his ministry, first thing that happened to him is open heaven. Matthew chapter 3, verse 13 to 16. Before Jesus Christ our Lord, when he come to the earth, the Son of the living God, before he start to practice anything, his heaven open. He did something that make his heaven open. Matthew 3, 13, 16. That means you cannot function if your heaven is not open. Matthew 3, 16 and 13, 16. Is anyone there? Please read quickly. Matthew 3, 13 to 16. I'm supposed to be having a fast reader among the deacons and all the of them. All the choir.
Then Jesus came from Galilee to John and John.
Jesus came from, yes.
And
yes.
Are you coming to me?
Uh-huh.
Jesus answered and said to him,
yes.
Permit it to be so now.
Uh-huh.
For thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness.
It is fitting for us now. Listen, let me give you one key. One of the fastest keys that make your heaven open is humility.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
What did I say?
Humility.
Humility. Stop proud. Stop arrogant. Whatever you want to be, someone has been there.
Yes.
You are not going to be the first and the last. Somebody will still come. Hello?
Hi.
Humility make your heaven open. God give you a little bit every day. You don't allow anybody to hear what again. God give you understanding of whatever it is. There every day, you raise your hand. No, by the time we talk, nobody can talk like us. Oh. Oh. It pains me when many pastors say, by the time I pray for you, who are you? You need the Holy Ghost to pray for somebody. We pray. By the time we pray for you, you and Holy Ghost is who pray. What about if you pray, the prayer is no answer? Come, I'll just touch you and your case will. At the end of the day, failure will come. You start to brag. Where did you put Holy Spirit that is involved? Humility. Jesus Christ know that the ministry of John is to baptize him. He know John as his senior brother. He said, no, you have to do this. I have to go in the way it's supposed to be. Now if he saw us, he said, brother John, come here. You know, I'm the son of the living God. So you need to understand that I see you in everything. No. Humble yourself. Tell your neighbor, humble yourself.
Humble yourself.
See, why opportunity is missing from us every day is because we refuse to humble. So heaven keep closing. God hates the proud. He loves the what? The humble. So one of the things that shut heaven against people is pride. Pride. Nobody can talk to me. I got this. Every day you got it, you are leaking.
Yes.
Continue.
Then he allowed him.
He allowed him.
When he had been baptized.
Quickly, yes.
Jesus came up immediately from the water.
Uh-huh.
And behold, the heavens were opened.
The heaven what? Open. When heaven open, that is when your access will be granted.
Yes.
Things will start to fall into place. That career you have struggled with, It's because heaven of the career is not open. That marriage is because the heaven of the marriage is not open. A man can be handsome, it may be wonderful, but when the heaven of the marriage is not open, it will be abuser. A woman can be pretty. When the heaven is not open, what is not supposed to possess her is what will possess her, it will be tormenting you. You do ask, Lord, let the heaven of this marriage open. When heaven open, easy access. Everything will become easy. Take your battle to the heavens, not earth. Sovereignty. Challenge heaven. Daniel prayed. The Bible said the first thing that Daniel prayed, his prayer is granted. But the prince of Persia, which is the second in the heavens, stopped the angels of the blessing. The reason why so many people have turned pastor to a liar now, make them to feel like as if God did not talk to them. When their heaven is in trouble, when there is satanic custom in their whole heaven that block their goods, they call pastor all manner of things. And heaven grows small. I'm getting that. I'll tell you something here today. So when Jesus Christ want to start his ministry, he called for heaven, open heaven. So when enemy wants to destroy any destiny, they will close the heaven or make the person to do abominative things that will close the heaven. When enemy wants to deal with you, they will cause you to do things that you are not supposed to do because they know once heaven shut against you, you start struggling. They will make you to take a wrong step. Beloved, it doesn't matter the year you have been a Christian. When heaven close, your Christianity will not have fruitfulness. It will not be a result. People will be asking, you sure you are serving God? Somebody can join the body of Christ today and they haven't hope. And results start to happen. This is different between three or two people that they are believers. One heaven is open little, one heaven is open wide, the rest one, the heaven is not open. Then the one that is heaven open say, is it not the same church where I go, oh, pastor is doing special prayer for you? Even pastor do special prayer for you if he did not see that your heaven is closed. And even though if you did not address your heaven, you will continue to be under the same oppression. I'm telling you. Many, many years ago, the man that stands before you is a living testimony to what I'm telling you here today. I will pray for a lot of people. It's me that I will pray. It's another person that I will take care of. Then the Lord said, what? I said, there is one that is even so funny. I brought four people to crusade. I'm the one that sing, do worship, praise, prayer, prophesy, do everything, do deliverance, run and fight with the demon that is coming out of them. You know, hey, you must get out. You must get out. But at the end of the day, when those people give a good something, these two people just sit on the other side, bring the offering. They collected, they took almost 36,000. Guess what? How much are they giving? 60 naira. Pastor, we are still paying for a marriage that we just did. God, anointing of God will continue to come upon you and say, eh? With this 60 naira, that is why we make anointing to continue. Anointing will drive with this one. Praise the Lord. Amen. Then I got to ask yourself some questions. When something that is not happening before starts to happen to you, check yourself. I got to. I was on my bed, I was provoking in my spirit. I said, Lord, there is something wrong with me. Something wrong. It's not about the money, it's about the way this thing is going on. It's not right. And the Lord said, you want to know? I said, yes. Your heaven is not open. I said, how this one? My fasting, my prayer. He said, yes, it's not open in the area where you are operating. I said, what would I do? He said, enter into 9 days dry fasting with me. And I enter. I said, if I would die here, I would die. My heaven, open. My heaven, open. My heaven, open. Every day. Now, my neighbor, they are kind of curious neighbor. You know, I have a neighbor that before I born again, or before I become what God made me, we used to disturb each other. So when they see that, I'm going, you know, when you are on the dry fasting, then one is shukuni, his mouth is over. Austin, don't kill yourself. Don't kill yourself. If you are trying to get money this way, it's not going to happen. You didn't know what I'm doing. But you see that son of mine is dry, kind of. I couldn't talk because it's a serious provocation. I look at you and say, ah. You know, it now becomes me and breeze. Because I'm showering every few minutes to sustain myself. You say, oh, Austin, don't kill yourself. If it's because of money, don't can't get it. You say, are you trying to do something? But to the glory of God, after my heaven opened, I didn't live in face me and trouble you more than 2 months interval. I moved to a bigger house. Now those, the man that said, Austin, don't kill yourself, the last time he saw me, he was on knee. Please pray for me. Pray for me. I cannot understand that something different is on you. Pray for me. Rise up on your feet. I'd like you to pray this prayer again before we sit down. Say, my heaven! Open by fire in the name of Jesus.
Let it open by fire.
Somebody talk to God here this morning. Masaka paraba koshenta, ribaka paraba lava koshenta lava. Somebody talk to God. Aha, 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 aha. Masaka paraba koshenta lava. Something is up here. Continue.
I don't want to exist.
In the name. Masaka paraba koshenta. In Jesus, mighty name we pray. And I say, let's continue. When you are not paying your tithe, it can be under a serious close heaven. People think paying tithe is about because church wants it. No. It's mandatory. And it's helpful. If there, Malachi chapter 3 verse 8. Open your Bible to Malachi 3. That is the last verse of the Bible. In Old Testament. In Old Testament, he said, will a man rob God? Yeah, you have robbed me, but you are, how have you robbed me? In tithe and offering, you are cursed with a curse for you are robbing me. The whole nation of you, bring the whole tithe into the storehouse so there may be food in my house. And test me now in this, say the Lord of hosts. I will not open for you the window of heaven and pour out a blessing. So, that means I will open. If you are a tither, you will never be under a closed heaven.
Yeah.
Never. I don't give because I'm a pastor. I give because I understand scripture. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What has been helping me personally is giving. Is tithe. This church, if it's $5 that is the offering, the tithe must be removed. This church pay tithe. And I pay my personal tithe. I don't say I'm a pastor. A few days ago, someone sent me 3,000 euro from Europe. I removed the tithe. In Nigeria, someone sent me 100,000. I told the person that, I said, take the tithe, pay the tithe, then share the whole money for all every other pastor. My sister that called, I said, what kind of person are you? Don't you think we'll, you? I said, no. Leave it like that. I will not struggle because why? I know I will be blessed.
Amen.
Why? Because I'm doing the principle. I will not preach what I don't practice to you. Hello?
Hi.
When you are not paying tithe, you will be on that close level of financial blessing. It's not nobody. See, many people think, oh, it's because pastor wants to eat my money. It's not your money. It's the part of what God have approved that you must give to him. Because he gave you life to do the job. Hello? Are you hearing true?
Yes.
If you are not paying tithe, you are coming under curse. And curse is one of the things that bring people under close heaven. The reason why many people are struggling financially today, and they are struggling every day, because they feel that they are too smart. Oh, I will not give any pastor my money to enjoy. Maybe you see me, I wear this suit now. Oh, he says, see, that's one of the things. It's not about what you... See, this suit was bought for me by somebody that is not even a member of this church. $700 by herself. She's not coming to this church. And I didn't ask her, oh, no, can you buy me suit? Never. No suit close to me, no. Even when God tell me to tell you to buy me, do something, I'm not. Because I hate insult. I don't want to wear the cloth, you'll begin to monitor me. Hey, that is the cloth I bought for pastor. And we are fond of that, we do it. Hello? You give pastor $200, the day he dresses and says, my money is working. You know what? I'm going to show you something here this morning. For you not to be under close heaven, you must understand the principle. If you don't understand, enough of struggling, enough of going through as if God is not alive, enough of making God to be mocked in your life, that people begin to ask you, are you sure you are serving God when you are the one that you have already caused what close heaven? What are the things that heaven can close on? Quickly. Because the Bible makes me to understand, heaven can be brass. Deuteronomy 28 verse 23. Say, if you refuse to obey me and do what I send you to do, I will make your heaven to be a brass heaven. That means the heaven will lock up. He will steal. He will steal. What are the things that can operate under close heaven? Number one, individual. Individual can be under a close heaven. Who are those who close in heaven affect? I'm talking about those who close heaven affect. Family. Family can be under close heaven. Disaster upon disaster, challenges upon challenges, that's what's going to be happening. Every day is going to be chaos. When you check that the man that used to pamper you before, the woman that used to love you before, all of a sudden is fight, your heaven is affecting something. You say, oh, good morning, on this. He asks you the question, what is good in the morning? All the children begin to cause a lot of problems. And you are not training them in that way. You did everything to make them happy. Still, they are not giving you happiness. Check your heaven. When heaven is closed, there will be sign everywhere. Amen?
Amen.
Number three, companies. Company can be under a close heaven. When a company is under close heaven, everybody working under that company, they will not enjoy anything. The money will become a cost money. Everything that is coming from that company will become affliction. People will become a spiritual slavery. They will start to struggle. They will be working, but they are not happy when the company is under close heaven. Number four, ministry can be under a close heaven. When God wants to punish a ministry that is no longer yield to his instruction, he closed the heaven. So such a ministry, you pray. Pray and pray, you will not hear any tangible testimony. People will start to form testimony. You will call quickly, somebody that will call one or two people and say, oh, by Sunday, please come. Come and share this so that people can be encouraged. And I give God the glory. Nobody in this place can ever say, I ever want to call him. Because why? Every testimony, if it's happening to me, why would it happen to you? Hello?
Hi.
If it's happening to me, why would it happen to you? Hello?
Hi.
It's from glory to glory. Amen. It starts from the head. Amen. When the head is straight, body will be straight.
Amen.
Hello?
Hi.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. What are the other things that close heaven can affect a nation? When a nation is under close heaven, it's going to be serious trouble. calamity upon calamity, battle, war will begin to be under of the day. Number six, generation can be under a close heaven. Because of our time, so that we can pray. What are the things that can bring close heaven? What are the things that can bring heaven to be close? Number one, sin. When you are into sin consistent, your heaven will be close. Number two, lack of instruction. When you lack instruction, heaven will close against you. Doesn't matter how you close to God, if God said do this way and you do it your own way, He will close heaven immediately. Are you still following me? Number three, lack of tithe and offering. When you are not paying tithe and offering, or you are short pay, your tithe is 100, you drop 80, say God will understand. You are not paying at all. If you pay $9.99 in your tithe, you didn't pay. As long as it's not complete that 10%, tithe is not something you negotiate with God. It's something you have to remove out of whatever God gives to you. Just like Apostle Adekunle, our guest said, say one sister was asking, is it gross or net? I said, people can always look for a way to do God. Gross or net. Amen. Number four, what are the things that bring close heaven? When you are attacking a God servant, when you are enemy of God servant, let me say this to you, not because I'm a pastor. The only people you can avoid not to have problem with in life is servant of God. See, if you have problem with your father and your mother, if they cause trouble for you, God can use the servant to change it. But if you have problem with the servant of God, they pronounce curse on you, you may say, it's not the day a child curses a big tree that died. When a servant of God curses you, you have to take another servant of God in that category or above that person to remove that curse. And if he must remove that curse, he will cause him a lot of trouble. That is why you are not happy with any pastor, just go your way. Avoid what? Trouble. Go your what? Go your way. Just say, thank you, sir. I'm not agree with you, but I'm not going to fight with you. Instead of me saying, I will show him, hey, this is America, I have my right. Oh, your right will not save your destiny. It's not the day your heaven closed that you start to see the result. It may be 2 or 3 months, it may be 6 months. And before you train, a woman came to a particular church and the pastor was preaching and she said, what is he saying? All these people that they are just talking anyhow. The man that he said it to did not even know that she is. She went out after the service, in 3 days interval, they plant stone inside her tummy. The angels of God plant stone into her stomach. She carried that stone like a pregnant. She thought she's pregnant. It's on, after 1 year, realized that he's not pregnant. And that was in her tummy for 3 years. Until when he come in contact with a prophet who can see deep. The prophet now told her, who did you is on when he's preaching? She now remember after 3 years of suffering. Then he went to the man to go and beg. Man said, I don't even remember you eased on me. But because you eased, still use your mouth to be rubbing ground. I'm going to ask God for forgiveness. Now after prayer, that is when that stone disappeared. There is people that you don't talk anyhow to. You may be their age mates. You may even be the one that give birth to them. But once you see that they are called servant of God, stay away from them. You are not to judge them. Let God judge them. Hello?
Hi.
The scripture says, he did not put his judgment into your hand. They call God, right? Let God judge them. If they do good, they do bad, he will figure them out. Their punishment is too dangerous. When God wants to deal with them, you cannot help them. Amen?
Amen.
If anyone that is not doing it right, and is there, deceiving or manipulating them. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes,
not because I'm a pastor. I'm telling you the blunt truth. I've been under many servants of God. The one that do me bad, the one that do me good. Thank you, sir. Because I know the scripture says, touch not my anointed, and do not my prophet no. Is that clear to you?
Yes, sir.
What can bring you under close heaven? Worshipping idol. Psalm 186, verse 15. When you are worshipping idol, how many people are worshipping idol without them know? They'll buy toys, all these dog baby. They give it to their children. Take it, play with it. You are programming idol into your home. Read Psalm 136. Quickly, verse 15. Now, Psalm 135, sorry. Say, the idol of the nation, but silver and gold, the work of man's hands. And they have mouth, but they do not speak. They have eyes, but they do not see. They have hear, but they do not hear. Don't they have any breath at all in their mouth? Those who make them like them. Is it your Bible?
Yeah.
You read it to 19. I mean to 18. So you can read it when you get to because of our time. What are the things that bring heaven to close? Negative covenant. When you are under any covenant that is not of God, it will bring heaven to close. What are the things that make heaven to close again? Curse. There is not the purpose of curse. When you see anyone issue curse, he uses it to close heaven. Any curse. Please, any children that are making noise, let their parents take care of them. Every curse, silence and close your heaven. Don't joke with any cause at all. Somebody is playing with you. And he said in America because they joke with cause. Don't let anybody play with cause with you. If you are ashamed of that person, immediately say, I reject it. If you know that somebody you respect that, oh, you don't want to look at his face so that we look at you with despair. Oh, well, it's not going to better for you. I reject it, sir. You did not say bad word to the person, but you say you do what?
You reject
it. Amen?
Amen.
Little cross is like a little water that make ocean. They pile up to become deep. Your parent calls you, say, oh, after all, it's my mother. He will understand that he cannot say. Who said that? Overstand. Because mother, they're like an idol. The word that come out of their mouth stand immediately. So please, people of God, mother here, watch what you say to your children. Oh, you are troubling me. As you are troubling me, your destiny will be troubled. The way you are doing that, they will do that to you. You are cursing. They will rise you and drop you like that. What your father did to me, he dropped me anyhow, they will drop you anyhow. Who sent you to the father? Don't bring your own hypocrite, your own punishment to the children. They didn't send you to go and enter the market that you don't want to price. Amen?
Amen?
So think very well. Don't stop cursing. Every curse, close heaven. Many people have been cursed from teenage, from when they are young. And they do not understand. And they struggle up to now. That's why we need to pray here this morning. That Lord, my heaven was open. Whatever that has blocked my heaven, let it be removed.
Amen.
Can I hear you say that? Amen?
Amen.
The last one is vow that not paid. It's better not to make a vow than make a vow and you don't pay it at all. Any form of any vow, be it to individual, be it to church, be it to anywhere. You see a woman say, oh, I swear, if I don't marry you, I will die. Now, after you have what you want to have, now you cross and say, I just play fast on you. You don't know what is going on. It's not the day your breath move out of you, that is the day you die. So many people have died walking. There is a lot of death that they are still breathing. Spiritual death is in the kingdom that God, if God open your eye, please, anything you know you cannot pay, don't make the vow. He said, never make bad with your head because you cannot create the hair. Don't make bad with any of your body. So he said, hey, I'll bow over the life of this my son. I will do this. And after they didn't do it, they put that son in problem. I vow. Some people come to church, then pastor is not there, nobody is there. Lord, if you can give me this job, the first salary I'll give to you, the second salary I'll give to you, the third one I'll give it to you. You know you cannot even give half. And you are saying, you think, oh, nobody is there. You say, I said it quietly after all, nobody is there. Who said that to you? Even in your room, that you think God is not there. If you are praying in your room, God answer, what do you think will make you vow in your room and God will not take it? Am I talking to someone here?
Yes, sir.
Think here this morning, if there's any vow you've made, wherever you make it. I've shared here before, I made a vow of 50,000 back in Africa. And when I came to America, I couldn't see who I would see send that money to, because those who I would think I'll send, they will not be able to take it to exactly place where I made the vow. And if you made the vow in a place and you don't take the vow there, you didn't pay the vow. And every day, if I'm praying and I'm worshiping God, God will say, you're a liar, you're a thief. What did I do? The vow. What did I do? Until I saw somebody, I said, listen, take, this is 20,000, this is 50. Take this 20,000 so that you will not touch this 50. If you touch this 50, I will curse you. Say, oh no, you have given 20,000. I said, please go straight to so-so place. I know your transport there will not more than 2,000. You greedy, IS is 55, so you still have 15 profit. Go straight to that place. Enter there. My name, my wife name, my son name that I made that vow, put it there and put the vow. And immediately, the person did it. I saw the signal here. And I saw it in that, okay. He had not come when I say you did it in so-so time. He said, you follow me. I said, ah, I'm monitoring it. Praise the Lord. So if you are on any vow, you don't pay, it's dangerous. Amen. Are you still following me?
Yes, sir.
If you are following me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So for something great to happen, there must be open heaven. Now, if your life must become a showcase, that everybody will begin to say, Lord, I thank God for this person, your heaven must open. So what will happen when what do you need to do? The key for your heaven to open. The key for things that you need to do for your heaven to open. Number one, what are the things that you need to do for your heaven to open here this morning? You must be a friend of God. That is repentance, relationship. You must have a relationship with God. It's not a one-time thing. When we're talking about relationship, a consistent relationship, your heaven will always open. Number two, you must worship God. Worship Him. Every time you worship God, you are sustaining your heaven. Your heaven is like your credit in America. A Christian that is heaven is not sustained open, because when heaven opens, if you are not consistent, it can be closed. One of the attack of the devil is to close your heaven, because he knows once your heaven closes, you'll be under hardship. Amen? Amen? So consistent worship. Luke chapter 3, 21. Luke 3, 21. When you get home, you can read that one. Or let's read quickly so that you can see. Luke 3, 21. You see that one? Now when all people were baptized, Jesus was also baptized, and while he was praying, heaven was open. Right? Number three, praise. Praise. A man or woman who knows how to praise God will live under open heaven. When you know how to praise God, you will live under open heaven. That is why we love praises in this ministry. You will need to understand it. Praise will calm God's presence down. God loves praise, and when you praise God, He will come down. God cannot come down and heaven still remain closed. Amen?
Amen?
Prayer and fasting, consistent prayer and fasting. Luke, Exodus 19, 18. Acts chapter 10, verse 9 to 6. Acts chapter 10. Acts of Apostles, chapter 10. Is anyone there? Verse 9 to 6. So on the next day, as they were on their way, approaching the city, Peter went up in the upper about the sixth hour to pray. But he came hungry, and while desiring to eat, but while they were making preparation, he fell into a trance, and he saw the sky open up. And the object like it. So when you are praying, a man or woman of prayer will always live under open heaven. Not all this one that people pray 2 minutes. Father, I thank you because I know you understand. In Jesus' name. That is the end of the day. No coming back again and pray. Oh, second day. Father, I thank you. I know as I pick how you be with me in Jesus' name. So, but the day there is a trouble, that is the day you are not going to have a different session of prayer. Oh Lord. Lord! You can hear me, right? You are a drama. Why is it when you have challenges, that is when you know how to pray? The Bible says, pray without ceasing. When you want your heaven to open, mention God in prayer. It's like a way of communication. Keep talking to Him. A man that you want is to be open his house to you every time, you must be communicating with the person. It's like the way we live. I want to always come into your house. If I'm not communicating with you, can you open your door for me? No. I talked to you once in a 3 months. I will suspect you when you are coming to my house. Hello? That's like, but if we are talking every day, anytime you knock my door, Pastor, are you there? Come inside. But you talk to me once in 3 months, I will suspect you. Because in the world we are into, everybody is a suspect. Okay, tell your neighbor, are you a suspect? Shout hallelujah. So the next thing to do for your heaven to open, giving. Beloved, either you like it or not, giving is essential. Giving is one of the things that open heaven. Always. You don't give because you want to oppress. You don't give because you want to showcase. You don't give because you want people to recognize. Give from your heart. You know that I want to come and give you $50 now. Oh, have you seen Sister Juliana? I want to give her $50. Oh. Where is that? You've already let everybody know you want to give Sister Juliana. So, the whole choir already know that Sister Juliana is getting $50 from you. Or you are coming to church to come and give offering, or you want to come and give pastor something. Do you know pastor number? No, I didn't know pastor number. Oh, this pastor self. It's when I want to give him something now. Do you know pastor number? I didn't know. Oh, I have it. Okay, give him. Even though if I call him now, I don't know, maybe we're available because I want to give him something. Do you know pastor number? After someone I give you the number. The Bible says whatever you want to give to the right time, don't let laughter know. You are giving the old word already know. You start from 69 to 94. I'm the one that is carrying that church. If I don't come to that church, you see very soon they will fall. And the major thing, my tithe in that church is what is keeping pastor. You cannot enjoy open heaven. Beloved, this is what is affecting us. We are giving with pride. So the result of the giving is not attached anymore. Because you are giving to showcase, you want people to know. You mistakenly buy shoe for your friend. You don't want to know you buy shoe. Did they not greet you? Say, don't mind that. Why would you not greet me? You will see the shoe that you wear next week. The shoe. That baby shower, you will see. The shoe I bought for you. Will see. So everybody already know that the sister that is coming with a brown shoe to baby shower is from you. Amen? Don't do that. You cannot enjoy open level. Sister, you are the one taking care of our home. You should not let anybody know. Brother, you are the major supplier of the house. That is why God put you there. You don't let anybody know. The whole world must not know that you are the one carrying the whole family. It's inward. You are sowing a seed that God will reward you with.
Yes.
Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
This morning, it may be bitter, but it's truth.
Yes.
If I stand as a prophet of God, I didn't tell you what you need to enjoy God, I'm not doing my job. What are the things you need to do? Avoid curse. Avoid being cursed. Don't allow anything to bring curse on you at all. If you know someone has pronounced curse on you, if you cannot be the person, come to church. Confess the truth, sir. Somebody, so person have cursed me. Please pray for me. Then, or you come for deliverance, you break the curse and don't do things of curse anymore. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
What are the things you need to do again? Knowing the word of God. Know the word of God. The word of God will keep you consistent. The word of God is heavenly constitution that opens the gate of heaven every day. What are the things you need to do? Lastly, diligent obedience. Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to 14. If you obey, if you are can obey, you will eat the fruit of the land. So, obedient open heaven for you. Obedient is not about God alone. Obedient to the law of the land. Hello? You know DWI. What is it, DWI? Don't drink while you are driving. And you are a child of God, but 3 bottles of liquor, you always manage it. And when they now withdraw your license, they say, oh, somebody is after your life. You buy them, say, you don't need witches, you are the witch. You are the what? The witch by yourself. You know your marriage is not working because you are consistent in alcohol, in a midnight party, and you are thinking that, oh, it's devil, no devil. There's some things that you need to stop. If you don't stop there, nothing work. Disobedient, no matter how big it is disobedient to God, to man, to nation. You see, there's something that is going on and people are doing it, and when the repercussion will come, they will pay dearly for it. I'm going to say it clearly because God revealed it to me. You have 3 kids. You have borrowed another kid to do tax. You will pay back. That is a cheat. You are closing your heaven. I'm telling you the real truth today. You may not like me. I'm going to tell you the wrong truth. It's better you pay back than borrow another person's children. You are closing your heaven because you are cheating the nation. You are stealing from the nation. This is the reason why many people at the end of the day, they don't know what they make with their money. You live from year to year, nothing come out of it. You have 2 kids. You want to go and borrow another 2 kids from somebody so that you want to avoid paying back. So that they can say, oh, you are at the end of the day, and you know these children are not your own. They are smart, you are smart, we are smart sometimes. You may go away with God, but you cannot go away with God. Stop closing your heaven. Face reality. It's better you pay back. Pay back in 1 year, you see the way God will bless you. Because you have made the law of the nation. You didn't rob the nation. If you rob the nation, the money of the nation cannot do you good. Rise up, everything. I know so many people will say, oh, I don't just like this part at all. I don't like this part. I wish I don't come to church to hear this one today. Oh, Pastor said I've been talking good, but now he ended up with a word that I don't want to hear. It doesn't matter, the truth has to be said. It's better you know the truth. I am a prophet, I'm not a pastor. I will tell you the truth. Go with the truth.
Amen.
You don't like it? But when God wants to judge it, he will not bring the punishment on me because I'm telling you the truth.
Amen.
Hello?
Hi.
That is the point.
Amen.
Make restitution today. Make restitution. You will see, you need to check yourself. What is putting my money in bondage that not allow me to enjoy it? I'm working hard, but I'm not getting anything. Check all these things very well, you'll see the result. We are going to pray. But if you are here,